Ready, Carl Wine here, Wine Engines. Today I've got a unusual project. It's a 400 small block Chevy. It's a LT none. I'm always working on LT1s, but just for something to learn about, I took on this project. And I'm working on the cam thrust or the cam end play with a thrust button. And right now I have it installed. It's a little bit out of spec, and I'm going to show you what we have right now. We're going to go through how to get it in spec, or we're going to try to get it in spec, and we're going to try the different various, I guess they're like little roller thrust buttons made out of steel, and there's nylon. And stick with me. We'll figure it out. Hey, so what we got going on here is this CVR, high performance, two-piece timing cover. Right now there's a mechanical thrust button behind here. I have about 0.1, I have shims in there, shims behind it, and you'll see later. I stacked in three, and there's about, I guess, that equals up to almost 0.1. I think it's 0.08 thousandths of shim in there. The specs on this say to put those shims behind the mechanical roller thrust button, behind it, between the cam and it. And so what I did was have to take the cam out. I'll show you later. Anyway, it says the specs need to be 0.001 to 0.005. Let me show you what that is. If that's the cam going back in the block, right? The cam going that way is stopped by the cam gear. So this is the furthest back. I don't push too hard on it. Okay, so that's as far back as it goes. There's no adjusting that unless you do some, you put different old thrust washers on the back of the cam gear, or if you machine the back of the cam gear. So that's all the way back. I'll give it a light push to the forward because if you push a lot, it flexes the front. Looks like it's a 10 or an 11. So I need, that's thousandths. All right, so now I need at least a 0.005 in there. All right, so I'll take this all off. You'll see what I'm talking about if you haven't seen this before. Okay, look what we have. This little roller. So this will roll against the timing cover here. Notice I don't have the chain on. That's part of the instructions. They suggest to don't put the chain on until you're ready. And that's good because, let me take the cam out. See how this has a thrust plate. Okay. And well, the only thing I can think of is, I don't know. We'll see. Let's put that there. See, I do it with the cam out because I can't put those in there when it's in because they'll slide down. Put this button in there. Put the bolts in. They're not Loctited right now. Oh, I see what's happening.
these. See right here where I bolt tightened down on the button with the nut. And that may have, that kind of squished these a little too much.
Okay, now we have a button. So this will go in there once I put the cam in. So no chain, put the timing cover on, and actually it'll probably be no points. I mean, this will need to be ground down. Go through here. Move the cam all the way back. Set this at zero. Move the cam slightly. Wow. Now I have, look. I took the cam button too much. 40 thou. Bam. Ground it too much. About to get another one.